أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. We shall be beginning today with the fifth section of سورة الأنبياء. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولقد آتينا إبراهيم رشده من قبل وكنا به عالمين. إذ قال لأبيه وقومه ما هذه التماثيل التي أنتم لها عاكفون. قالوا وجدنا آبانا لها عابدين. قال لقد كنتم أنتم وآباؤكم في ضلال مبين. قالوا وجئتنا بالحق أم أنت من اللاعبين. صدق الله العظيم. In the next two sections of this Surah Anbiya, we have a mention of so many prophets and also some of the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have been having a list of the names of some of the prophets. We first of all had, and I said that it is a flower pot of the names of the prophets of Allah in Surah An-Nisa, again at one position in Surah Al Imran. But here it is going to be a bit in detail. But please be acquainted with two terms of Quran. Just as I have told you, that in order to awaken and activate within the human being the dormant consciousness about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Quran either refers to the signs and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, At-Tazkir bi-Ala Illah, or refers to the historical events, big days, when, you know, the big chastisement came to the nations to whom the messengers were sent. And that is called At-Tazkir bi-Ayyam Illah. In the same way, there are two terms regarding the accounts of the prophets and rusul and messengers of Allah in Quran. One is Amba'ur Rusul. Amba is the plural of Naba. Naba, it means a very important news, very big news. Amma yatasaloon anan naba'il azim illazi hum fiyeh mukhtalifoon. So Amba'ur Rusul, under this heading we have the account of those messengers of Allah whose nations were destroyed totally. I have named several times. To begin with, Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, then Hazrat Hud, Hazrat Saleh, Hazrat Lut, Hazrat Shuaib, Hazrat Musa. These six, their accounts are similar. They came to their nations, they called them to worship none except Allah and accept them as messengers of Allah. The nations as a whole rejected, and then as a punishment they were devastated, annihilated. But there is another account of the prophets. You know, their personal virtues, their high moral character, their perseverance, for example. So all these things, but not that they came and they demanded that obey me and have faith in me, and if you don't believe me, you will have chastisement. Not in that way. The most glaring example was in Surah Yusuf. In full 13 sections of that surah, the story of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam has been told in detail. But nowhere that better comes, that if the nation did not accept him, but neither the king of Egypt accepted him as a prophet, nor the nation as a whole of Egypt adopted him. So, but they were not devastated, annihilated, because he never claimed that I am messenger of Allah. So to be a prophet of Allah is something else, and to be a messenger of Allah is something else. So here you will find, you know, the mention of some of the prophets and the messengers also. Every messenger is definitely and necessarily a prophet also. Every prophet is not a messenger. But every messenger has to be a prophet first. And then actually he is selected, and then he is assigned a job to a particular place or to a particular people. So here we find, you know, the mention and this account and some of the prophets and messengers of Allah, but not in the form of Abba'ul Rusul, but in the way of Qasasun Nabiyyin. These are the stories of the prophets. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ رُشْدَهُ. And we had given Ibrahim min qabl. Before all these, we had given Ibrahim his guidance. وَكُنَّا بِهِ عَالَمِينَ. And we knew him absolutely. إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ. Now we have this mention, what Hazrat Ibrahim said to his father in Surah Maryam also. Here it is in a different way. إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ. Just recall when he said to his father and his nation, his people, مَا هَذِهِ التَّمَاثِيلُ الَّتِي أَنْتُمْ لَهَا عَاكِفُونَ. What are these images, these idols to which you are devoted? You sit concentrating your attention on them. قَالُوا وَجَدْنَا آبَاءَنَا لَهَا عَابِدِينَ. They said, we found our forefathers doing like this, worshipping them. So we are following them. We don't know why. What's the basis? What's the rationale? We don't know. But we found our forefathers doing like this, worshipping them. So we are following them. قَالَ لَقَدْ كُنْتُمْ أَنْتُمْ وَآبَاؤُكُمْ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. Now in very strong words, Ibrahim declared, no, not only you, but also your forefathers, they were in manifest error. They were wrong. Their way and path that they had taken was wrong. قَالُوا أَجَيْتَنَا بِالْحَقِّ أَمْ أَنْتَ مِنَ اللَّاعِبِينَ. Now they asked him, have you brought some absolute truth to us, or you are just joking? Maybe a young man is just joking. No, are you serious? أَجَيْتَنَا بِالْحَقِّ. Have you brought to us some absolute truth, or you are just joking? قَالَ بَلْ رَبُّكُمْ. He said, no, it's no joke. Your Lord is Rabbus Samawati wal Ard, the Lord of all the heavens and earth. Alladhi fatarahunna, who created them. He is the Lord of the heavens and earth, and He is the creator of the heavens and the earth. Wa ana ala zalikum min ash-shahideen. And I bear a testimony to this before you, that I don't believe in any God except the Lord of the heavens and the earth, who is also the creator of the heavens and the earth. وَتَاللَّهِ لَأَكِيدَنَّ أَصْنَامَكُمْ بَعْدَ أَن تُوَلُّوا مُدْبِرِينَ. And by God, I'll devise a plot against your idols when you go out turning your backs. There was going to be some big worship in the open field. Just you have in India Durga Puja or Kali Mai ki Puja. They go out in the field to make that worship. So the whole city was now empty. And Ibrahim said, well, I am not feeling well, I am not going with you. When the whole town was empty, then he entered the, there, you know, worshipping place where the idols were placed, and he broke all of them except one. So he said, Tallahi, by God, by Allah, I will certainly devise some plot against your idols after you have gone away, turning your backs. فَجَعَلَهُمْ جُزَازًا. So he broke them into pieces, fragments. إِلَّا كَبِيرًا لَهُمْ. Except the biggest idol. لَعَلَّهُمْ إِلَيْهِ يَرْجِعُونَ. So that they should refer to him. Ask him, who has done this? قَالُوا. When they came back and they were startled, what has happened? Just imagine if such an event takes place in the city of Mathura or the city of Banaras in India, what would happen? قَالُوا مَنْ فَعَلَ هَذَا بِعَالِهَتِنَا. Who is the one who has done this to our Lord, our gods? إِنَّهُ لَمِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Verily, he is a very big culprit. He is an evil doer. قالوا سمعنا فتى يذكرهم. Some people said we heard a youth. He used to mention them. يقال له إبراهيم. And his name is Ibrahim. He is called Ibrahim. He did use to mention them. قالوا فاتوا به على عيون الناس. They said, okay, bring him forth before the eyes of the people. لعلهم يشهدون. So that they also bear witness. قالوا أنت فعلت هذا بآلهتنا يا إبراهيم. And now they asked, before that mob is there alone. The mob is there. And how angry that mob would have been, we can imagine. قالوا أنت فعلت هذا بآلهتنا يا إبراهيم. Oh Ibrahim, have you done this to our gods, our idols? قال بل فعله كبيرهم هذا فسلوهم إن كانوا ينطقون. He said, this bigger one must have done this. He is safe. All the other are broken. So you ask him. He is a witness. He must have seen who has done it. Or might be he has done it. بَلْ فَعَلَهُ كَبِيرُهُمْ عَذَا فَسَلُوهُمْ إِنْ كَانُوا يَنْتِقُونَ. Now if they speak, ask them. فَرَجَعُوا إِلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Now this is the moment when the truth dawned on them. So they turned to themselves and said, وَقَالُوا إِنَّكُمْ أَنْتُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. The truth of the matter is that actually you are the evil doers. What Ibrahim is saying is correct. They can't speak. They can't move. This bigger idol could not have broken all these smaller idols. Impossible. They can't move. They can't talk. And this one cannot tell us who did it. And then we worship him. Then. So the truth dawned on them. But then, summa nukisu ala kulubahim. But then they were made to hang their heads down, saying, لَقَدْ عَلِمْتَ مَا هَوْلَا يَنْتَقُورُ. Oh Ibrahim, you know, these idols, they can't speak. قَالَ فَتَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَنْفَعُكُمْ شَئِنْ وَلَا يَدُورُكُمْ. He said, then you worship besides Allah these things who can neither give you any profits, nor they can do you any harm. أُفِّلْ لَكُمْ. How disgusting, how disgusting. أُفِّلْ لَكُمْ وَلِمَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. And these whom you are worshipping besides Allah, أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. So don't you ponder? Don't you think about it? Don't you understand? قَالُوا حَرِّقُوهُ. They decided and said, now burn him. وَانْصُرُوا عَلِهَتَكُمْ. And help your gods, because he has done this insult to the gods, so now he must be burned alive. إِنْ كُنْتُمْ فَاعِلِينَ. If you are going to do something. But when he was thrown in the fire, قُلْنَا. We said to the fire, قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا لَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمُ. O fire, be you a coolness and safety for Ibrahim. Because fire is under the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So any command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fire or water or air, these elements of nature have to obey. وَأَرَادُوا بِهِ كَيْدًا فَجَعَلْنَاهُمُ الْأَخْسَرِينَ. They had devised a plot against him, but they were the worst losers. Why? Actually, they thought that when Ibrahim will be presented and there will be fire, you know, big, and when he will come to understand that he has been going, he would be thrown, then he will come to his senses and he will apologize and he will turn back to the beliefs of the community. But Ibrahim, you know, he persevered, although he was thrown. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ وَلُوتًا إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا لِلْعَالَمِينَ. But then Ibrahim made hijrah. He migrated from this country. Actually, he was born in Iraq, in Ur. But now when the nation, you know, they actually put him in the fire to burn him. Now we had to make hijrah from there. This is the rule with the messengers of Allah. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ. And we rescued him, Ibrahim, وَلُوتًا. And his nephew, Lut, إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Towards the land which we have blessed for the people of the world. وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ نَافِلَةً. And then we bestowed upon him a son, Ishaq عليه الصلاة والسلام, ويعقوب, a grandson, يعقوب عليه الصلاة والسلام, نَافِلَةً, in addition. وَكُلًّا جَعَلْنَا صَالِحِينَ. And all of them we made very righteous people. وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا. And we made them the leaders and guiders of humanity, who used to guide people with our command. وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْهِمْ فِعْلَ الْخَيْرَاتِ. And we sent them by revelation the good, how to do the good deeds, by إقام الصلاة and establishing of the prayers, وَإِتَاء الزَّكَاةِ and paying of zakah, وَكَانُوا لَنَا عَابِدِينَ. And they were, yes, they were worshipping us, and they were all obedient to us. وَلُوتًا آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا. In the same way, to Lut also, we gave the judgment and knowledge. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْقَرْيَةِ الَّتِي كَانَتْ تَعْمَلُ الْخَبَائِسِ. And we rescued him and delivered him from the city, from the township, whose people indulge in very foul and filthy deeds. Sodomy, you know, that was the bad deed of these people, of the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمًا صَوْئِينَ قَوْمَ صَوْئِينَ فَاسِقِينَ. Verily they were an evil people, transgressors. وَأَدْخَلْنَاهُ فِي رَحْمَتِنَا. And then we admitted him, Lut, in our mercy. إِنَّهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Verily he is from amongst the righteous people. وَنُوحًا إِذْ نَادَى مِنْ قَبْلِ. And just mention Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. When he had called to us, called upon us, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ. Then we responded. And we answered his call, his prayer. And we delivered him and his family مِنَ الْكَرْبِ الْعَظِيمِ, from the mighty distress. وَنَصَرْنَاهُ مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. And we helped him against those people who had belied our revelations. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمَ صَوْئِن. They were also a very wicked people. وَأَغْرَقْنَاهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. So we drowned them all together, all of them. وَدَاوُودَ وَسُلَيْمَانَ. And here again is a mention of Dawood and Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, the son and the father. Dawood is the father, Sulaiman is the son. إِذْ يَحْكُمَانِ فِي الْحَرْثِ إِذْ نَفَشَتْ فِيهِ غَنَمُ الْقَوْمِ. When they were judging, you know, a dispute regarding a field, a farm, wherein certain people's sheep strayed, pastured, and destroyed. إِذْ نَفَشَتْ فِيهِ غَنَمُ الْقَوْمِ وَكُنَّا لِحُكْمِهِمْ شَاهِدِينَ. And when they were judging, they were giving their judgment, we were listening, and we were present over there. You know, a person came with a complaint to Dawood alayhi salam. Well, there was a field which I cultivated, and my, you know, harvest was very, but the sheep and goats of this person, they entered it during the night and destroyed the whole of the field. Now what should I do? How to recompense? What should be the, you know, fine? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave an instantaneous insight to Hazrat Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. He was young. He said, now this should be done. The flock of this sheep and goats should be given to this person whose field has been destroyed. He should keep them, eat of them, drink their milk. And this field should be again cultivated by the person whose sheep are here. When the field is ready, again harvest is okay, then the field will be given to the owner of the field, and the flock of the sheep and goats will go back to the person who owned them. So this judgment was very much liked. فَفَهَمْنَاهَا سُلَيْمَان. So we made Sulaiman to understand it. فَقُلَّنْ آتَيْنَا حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا. And both of them, Dawood and Sulaiman, to both of them we had given the judgment and knowledge. وَسَخَّرْنَا مَعَ دَاوُودَ الْجِبَالِ. And we had subjected the mountains for Dawood alayhi salam. يُسَبِّحْنَا. to glorify their Lord with him, وَالطَّيْر, and not only the mountains, also the birds. وَكُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ, and we were the doers. وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ صَنَعَةَ لَبُوسٍ لَكُمْ, and we taught him the making of the metal course for you. لَتُحْسِنَكُمْ مِنْ بَعْسِكُمْ, so as to protect you in your fighting. فَالَنْتُمْ شَاكِرُونَ, so will you then be grateful? وَلَسُلَيْمَانَ الرِّيحَ عَاصِفَةً, and for Sulaiman we subjected the wind blowing strongly. تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِهِ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا, which blew moving at its command towards the land that we had blessed. وَكُنَّا بِهَا عَالَمِينَ, كُنَّا بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَالَمِينَ, and all the things were in our knowledge. وَمَنَ الشَّيَاطِينَ مَنْ يَغُوسُونَ لَهُ, and we subjected the satans, the jinns, for him. They used to dive for him in the oceans. وَيَعْمَلُونَ عَمَلًا دُونَ ذَلِكَ, and did some other works also beside that. Build very big buildings for him. وَكُنَّا لَهُمْ حَافِظِينَ, and we were watching over them. وَأَيُّوبَ, and mentioned Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, is Nada Rabbah, who had become very sick, very sick, very sick. Some skin disease, there were boils over the whole of the body, decaying, putrefied. Then you know there were insects moving in those wounds. So his family, his sons and daughters, they got fed up, left him. In the end, his wife also left him. But then he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he remained, you know, sabir and shakir. Never complained to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that what you have done to me. Whatever comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, okay. It's from him, so I accept it. This should be the attitude of a believer. So when he passed this test, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listened to his prayer and granted him his prayer. وَأَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ, when he called upon his Lord, أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ, O my Lord, affliction has touched me. وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ, and you are the most merciful of all those who have mercy. You have the maximum mercy. It was the appeal. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ, so we answered his call. فَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِ مِنْ دُرٍ, and we removed the affliction with which he was afflicted. وَآتَيْنَاهُ أَهْلَهُ, and we gave back him his family. All the family came back then to him. وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ, another family. Might be he had then married again, and he had another family. مِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ رَحْمَةً مِنْ عِنْدِنَا, this is all as a gesture of our mercy. وَذِكْرَ لِلْعَابِدِينَ, or this is a admonition for the worshippers. وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِدْرِيسَ وَذَلْكِفْلِ, and Ismail and Idris and Zulkifl, kullum min as-sabirin, they were all perseverant people. Now about Zulkifl, let me tell you that Quran gives this name twice, but rest no knowledge about it, who he was, where he was born, and which family, lineage, whose lineage, was the progeny of Ibrahim or somebody else, you know nothing from Quran. And we don't have any details in Hadith also. But there is an opinion of some ulama of India that Mahatma Gautama Buddha, Siddhartha Gautama Buddha, was Zulkifli. Because he was born in Kapalvastu. Kapalvastu, that, you know, state of the Raja of Kapalvastu, he was the son. So Kapal in Arabic becomes Kafl. Pay is not there, P or pay is not there. It turns into F or Fa. So Zulkafl, the person from Kapalvastu. And it is just possible. It's just possible, but we can't be sure about it. Kullu min as-sabirin, all of them were from the persevering people. وَأَدْخَلْنَاهُمْ فِي رَحْمَتِنَا, and we admitted them and made them enter our mercy. إِنَّهُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ, definitely they were from the righteous. وَظَنُّونَ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا, and the man of the fish. He is Jonah or Yunus alayhi salatu wassalam. He left his nation before the express permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a messenger is sent to some land or some people or some community, and the community has rejected him, but he cannot leave the community or that place without the express permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is stationed there, he is deputed there, he is appointed there as messenger of Allah, a representative of Allah. But you know, he got so much fed up with the people and their arrogance that he left without the permission of Allah. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished him. He was swallowed by a big fish, maybe some whale. For some time he remained in the stomach of that whale. But then this whale, you know, vomited him out on the shore. And then, you know, he recovered. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his repenting and his tawbah and his apologies. وَظَنُّون is ذَهَبَ مُغَازِبًا. And ذَنُّون, نُون means fish. ذُنُّون, the man of fish. Recall when he went away enraged. And he thought, فَظَنَّ أَلَّا نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ. And he thought, we could not have any power over him. فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ. But then he had to call upon us in the darkness of the stomach of that fish, that whale. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-ghalibin. There's no God except you, O Lord, O Allah. Glory be to you. Inni kuntu min al-ghalibin. I accept that I was the evil doer. I have committed a mistake. I did wrong. I was wrong in leaving my nation before, without your express permission. And you may recall that, you know, when the permission was given to the companions by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to migrate to Medina, he himself kept back at Makkah, waiting for the express permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala used to ask him, O Messenger of Allah, has the permission come? No. Has the permission come? No. Because he was preparing two camels, feeding them and making them strong, so that we have to rush then from Makkah to Medina. So all preparation was done by Abu Bakr. But he kept on asking, has the permission come? And the Prophet said, no. Suddenly then, at noon, you know, it's very strange in the Arabian society, nobody visits others' house at noon, because they have that talula, they sleep during the noon. But at the noon, high noon, the Prophet came to the house of Hazrat Abu Bakr and told him that the permission has come. And then they started their journey. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. So we answered the prayer of Yunus alayhi salam also, وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمِ. And we delivered him from the grief. وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And in this manner, this is our rule, that we deliver the believers. But Zakariya, and just mentioned Zakariya alayhi salatu wassalam, his story we have just read in Surah Maryam. That was a full section. Here is only two ayat. But Zakariya is nada rabbahu, when he called upon his Lord, Rabbi la tadarni fardan. Oh my Lord, don't leave me alone without a son. Alone. If I die, my name is gone. My dynasty finished. And who will look after the mission of the prophetic mission that you have entrusted to me? Who will take it over? La tadarni fardan wa anta khairul warisin. You are the best inheritor, okay? If I don't have an inheritor, you are the best inheritor. I accept. But it would be better if you give me a son. Fastajabna lahu. So we answered his prayer also. Wa wahabna lahu Yahya. And we bestowed upon him a son, Yahya. وَأَصْلَحْنَا لَهُ زَوْجَهُ. And we cured for him his wife, who had been barren up till that time. But now she conceived and she bore a son. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ. These people, this family as a whole, They were the people who were competing each other in good deeds. Everyone wanted to go forward, more forward. And this is a society of the believers. Each one of them wants to do more, more good. Not competing in the worldly things. Well, if he has a big house, I should have a bigger one. No, no, no. The competition is in good deeds, in the service to Allah, in the service for his deen. Who goes more? Who does more? So that was, يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَحْبًا. And they used to call upon us, make dua to us. And in both ways, رَغَبًا, having, you know, that we should give them mercy, وَرَحْبًا, and fearing us also. So this calling upon Allah should have both these things. We should have fear also and hope also. Hope of his forgiveness, fear of his punishment. وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ, and they were very humble before us. وَالَّتِي أَحْسَنَتْ فَرْجَهَا فَنَفَقْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ رُوحِنَا. And now the last mention is of Maryam, salamu alayha. And that girl or woman who had guarded her chastity fully, then we blew in her from our own spirit. وَجَعَلْنَاهَا بْنَاهَا وَابْنَهَا آيَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. And we made her and her son signs for the worlds. إِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً. Now as if Allah is addressing these people, Ibrahim, Nuh, Lut, and Yunus, and all these people, the messengers and prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً. O prophets and messengers, this is the community of yours, and it is one community. We have made communities separate. This is the community or ummah of Musa. This is the community or ummah of Isa. This is the community and ummah of such and such Nabi. No. It's all one. You are all one. They were all servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They all believed in one God. They were all sent by the same Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in hadhihi ummatukum ummatan wahida, this community of yours is one community. Wa ana rabbukum fa'budun, and I am your Lord, so continue worshipping me. Wa taqatta'u amrahum bainahum kullun ilayna raji'un, but then they split up their affairs among them, and they all will return to us. After these people passed away, now there were the sects. They are the Jews, they are the Christians, and these are such, and these are such. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِنَ الصَّالِحَاتِ. Now what is the rule with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Whosoever does good deeds, وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. And the condition is that he should be a believer. فَلَا كُفْرَانَ لِسَعْيِهِ. So his striving for good deeds will not be rejected or disapproved. وَإِنَّا لَهُ كَاتِبُونَ, and we are writing and recording all the good deeds they are doing. وَحَرَامٌ عَلَىٰ قَرْيَةٍ أَهْلَكْنَاهَا أَنَّهُمْ لَا يَرْجِعُونَ. And it is forbidden for the people of a city which is going to be destroyed, for which Allah's command is destruction, the final chastisement from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now it is forbidden for the people, they can't return. It can have two meanings. They can't repent. They can't go to Allah's, you know, call and accept it. Because now the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already come. خَتَبَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ سَمْرِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ أَبْصَارِهِمْ غِشَاوَةٌ. Now they cannot come back. Secondly, once destroyed and gone from this world, they cannot return to this world. They are gone, gone by the wind. They cannot come back. حَتَّى إِذَا فُتِحَتْ يَعْجُوجُ وَمَعْجُوجُ. This thing with the communities will continue happening till such time that the Gog and Magog are opened, let loose. وَهُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ حَلَبٍ يَنْسِلُونَ. And you will see them. They will be coming down from every mound. Now who are these Gog and Magog? It's a controversial issue. One thing is sure. Gog and Magog are among the names of the sons of the third son of Nuh alayhi salam. Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam had three sons, Sam, Ham, Yafis. The progeny of Sam settled, because you know, where did Nuh live? The area which we call today Kurdistan. This is a place where three, four countries meet together. North of Iraq, northwest of Iran, east of Turkey and Syria, and then Russia or the USSR, the Caucasia. These countries merge here, and this was the place abode of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam and his people. And there is that hillock, you know, where the ark came to stay after the flood was gone. Now from there, you know, these three sons, when they came out from the ark, so Sam descended southward, Iraq, Sham, and the Arabian Peninsula. These nations were called the Semitic nations. Ibrahim was Semitic. He was from Iraq. Syrians, Semitic. Arabians, Semitic. Muhammad is Semitic, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All the prophets of the Old Testament, they are all progeny of Ibrahim, they are Semitics. Number two, Ham. The progeny of Ham spread to the east and to the west, not downward, not to the south. Iran and India. And on the other side, Egypt and Sudan, and some East European countries. This is the progeny of Hazrat Ham. But the progeny of Hazrat Yafis, that crossed over the mountains of Central Asia, and then they spread to the east and west. So China, Mongolia, Russia, because among their sons is Tobal and Mosk. One name is Mosk, maybe Moscow might have been, you know, founded by that son of Yafis. So these are the nations of Gog and Magog. And they were the people to, for them, you know, that wall was erected by, as we had read in Surah Al-Kahf, by Dhul-Qarnayn, between the Caspian Sea and the Black Sea. This is, you know, a very broad pass through which these people used to come and plunder the nations which were settled in the plains in the, to the south. But then he erected the wall over there and stopped so that they couldn't come and invade. So these are Gog and Magog. And it is in the Ahadith also, in many details, that near the end of this world, near Qiyamah, these nations will be let loose. They will bring havoc to this globe, destruction and havoc. And their final confrontation would be with Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. And even Hazrat Isa would have to withdraw from them to the mountains. They will be so formidable force, you know. They will drink all the water of the sea. Sea of Galilee will go dry because they will drink each and every drop of it. Now this scene, which Quran says, "Min kulli hadami yansalun," you will see these nations coming down, sliding down from all the slopes. This scene has once happened in history in 1962, when there was a war between India and China. And you know, the reports in the newspapers were, waves after waves of the Chinese soldiers were descending from the mountains, and what humiliation had, you know, India had to face at that time. A very big defeat, very shameful defeat at the hands of the, because in numbers they are very great. Chinese. And all this area, you know. So they are from the Gog and Magog. And they are all the progeny of Hazrat Yafis alayhi salatu wasalam. Hatta idha futihat Yajuj wa Majuj. Now this means, when that hour will come near of Qiyamah or As-Sa'ah, and these Yajuj and Majuj will be let loose. And you will see them coming down from all the slopes. Maybe the slopes of the mountains of the Central Asia also. And slopes of Himalayas, just as it was in the Nifa in 1962. Slopes of Himalayas, and they are coming down. Waves and waves of Chinese soldiers coming. You kill one, the other wave is coming. You murder all of them, the third wave is coming. So waves after waves of Chinese soldiers were coming down the slopes of the Himalayas. واقترب الوعد الحق. And at that time, the promise, time of that promise would come near. وعد الحق. But that is of the hour, the doomsday, the day of resurrection. فَإِذَا هِيَ شَاخِصَةُ الْأَبْصَارُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. And you will find that at that time, that the eyes of the disbelievers would be staring in terror. قَالُوا يَا وَيْلَنَا. They will say, oh, woe to us. قَدْ كُنَّا فِي غَفْلَةٍ مِّنْ هَذَا. We were heedless of this. We were never thought seriously that this can come to happen. The messengers of Allah foretold, but we never believed in them. بَلْ كُنَّا ظَالِمِينَ. We were actually the evil doers. إِنَّكُمْ وَمَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ حَسَمُ جَهَنَّمُ. But now, no use. Now you have to be, not only you, but those whom you have been worshipping, your idols, they will all be thrown in the fire of hell, and they will become, you know, a sort of wood. حَسَمُ جَهَنَّمُ. There they will be burnt away. لَوْ كَانَ هَؤُلَاءِ آلِهَةً. And at that time they will think that if these idols were gods, مَا وَرَدُوهَا, they should not have come to this fire of hell. وَكُلٌّ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. But all of them will have to live there forever, for eternity. لَهُمْ فِيهَا زَفِيرٌ وَهُمْ فِيهَا لَا يَسْمَعُونَ. They will be sighing there with deep sorrow and grief, but they will be able to listen nothing. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ سَبَقَتْ لَهُمْ مِنَّ الْحُسْنَى. On the contrary, verily those for whom a good word has already passed from us, ordained, we have ordained already. أُولَٰئِكَ عَنْهَا مُبْعَدُونَ. They will kept away from this Jahannam, this hell. لَا يَسْمَعُونَ حَسِيسًا. They will not have to hear only even its whisper. وَهُمْ فِي بَشْتَهَتْ أَنفُسُهُمْ خَالِدُونَ. And they will abide forever in those things which their souls desire. لَا يَحْزَنُهُمُ الْفَضْلُ الْأَكْبَرُ. The great terror shall not grieve them of Zalzala. Zalzala Tussa'a. The next surah is going to begin very soon. And the first word is, إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ تَسَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ. The earthquake at the time of the doomsday would be a very great event. But these people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will save them. The great terror shall not grieve them. لَا يَحْزَنُهُمُ الْفَضْلُ الْأَكْبَرُ وَتَتَلَقَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ. And Malaika, the angels will come and greet them. هَذَا يَوْمُكُمُ الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ. Now this day has come, which was promised to you. That is, now you will enter paradise. يَوْمَ نَتْوِي السَّمَاءَ كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ. Just imagine the day, the doomsday, when we shall roll up all the heavens, just as the rolling of a scroll for writing. You know, in the ancient days, books were not bound like this. They used to be in scrolls. One paper you have written, now paste another one. And you just roll it. And now second you are rolling. Rolling and rolling on, writing and rolling. So these are called the scrolls. Now today we don't have scrolls. We have books, bound books. Leaves and bound books. But the simile here is, يَوْمَ نَتْوِي السَّمَاءَ كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ. The day when we shall roll up heaven like the rolling up of a scroll for writing. كَمَا بَدَانَا أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ نُعِدَهُ. As we had originated them in the first creation, we shall restore it. وَعْدًا عَلَيْنَا. This is a promise binding on us. إِنَّا كُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ. And we shall definitely do it. Now here we can understand there's the theory of expanding universe. The universe is expanding, going on. But then there is a theory, the time will come when expansion will start. And inward rolling, reverse rolling will start. And that inverse rolling might be the whole universe again comes to one spot. Just as the galaxies have come to one holes, which we call the black holes, you know, in the space, black holes. There used to be some very big galaxy over here. It collapsed, and now there's only a hole. Very dreadly hole. Anything passing by that, goes there and vanishes. So in the same way, this whole universe might become again, you know, it started from one point, the Big Bang. And Big Bang, it started expanding and expanding and expanding. But a time will come when it will roll back and it will again come to the starting point. كَمَا بَدَانَا أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ نُعِيدُهُ As we had originated them in the first creation, we shall make them return to the same. وَلَقَدْ كَتَبْنَا فِي الزُّبُورِ مِنْ بَعْدِ الزِّكْرِ And we had written it down in Zabur, in Psalms, after the admonition, أَنَّ الْأَرْضَ يَرِسُهَا عِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحُونَ That the earth will inherit the land by righteous servants will inherit the land, the earth. Now it can have two meanings. Number one, that the earth here, the land here, which is mentioned is the land of paradise. The land of paradise will be inherited by people who have done good deeds, the believers. Another thing can mean that before the end of this world, a time will come that the whole this world will be ruled by the people who are righteous, who are servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to this effect, we have a clear prophecy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that before the end of this world, Islam will dominate the whole of the globe. لا يبقى على ظهر الأرض بيت وبر ولا بدر إلا أدخله الله كلمة الإسلام. The hadith in Musnad Ahmad ibn Hanbal from Miqdad ibn Aswad radiallahu anhu that not a single house will remain made of bricks and clay and not a single tent will remain of the nomads in which Allah will not make the deen of Allah, Islam, enter. This will happen. So a global domination of the deen of Allah. This is Khilafah ala minhaj al-Nubuwah. And the Prophet said, this period will come again. The Khilafah ala minhaj al-Nubuwah, just after the death of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that was the Khilafah Rashida, we know it. The caliphate, pious caliphate. The same system will again be established on this earth. So that this ayah can mean that also. وَلَقَدْ كَتَبْنَا فِي الزَّبُورِ مِنْ بَعْدِ الزِّكْرِ أَنَّ الْأَرْضَ يَرِسُهَا عِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحُونَ We had already written in Zabur, in Psalms, after the admonition, that this land will be inherited by our righteous servants. Either before the end of this world, there is a global domination of the Muslim Ummah and Islam established as a deen, as a social order over the whole of the world. Or after the end of this world, the land of paradise will be inherited by our righteous servants. إِنَّ فِي هَذَا لَبَلَاغًا لِقَوْمٍ عَابِدِينَ And in this is surely a message for the worshippers who worship us. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ And we have not sent you, O Muhammad, but a mercy for all the nations of the world. This is again a hint. Because if he has been sent for the whole of the world, now his deen, which he brought with him, must be dominant over the whole of the world. هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ He was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this deen of haqq in order to make it supreme. So when he has been sent for the whole of humanity and for all the world, so then the deen of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that is deenul haqq, that is deenullah. Deenullah and deenul Muhammad the same. That will dominate the whole of the globe. قُلْ إِنَّمَا يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is being revealed to me, this wahi has come to me, that your Lord is only one God. فَالَ أَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ So do you surrender yourself to him or not? فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا If they turn their faces, فَقُلْ أَعْذَنْتُكُمْ عَلَىٰ سَوَاهَ So proclaim that I have conveyed to you the message alike, all alike. I have spoken to the rich, to the poor. I have spoken to the high, to the low. I have preached in your streets. I have knocked at your doors. I have talked to you in privately. I have addressed you in public. I have done whatever I could do. آذنتكم على سواء وَإِنْ أَدْرِيَ قَرِيبًا بَعِيدٌ مَا تُوعَدُونَ Now this I don't know. whether the chastisement that is promised to you has come near or it is a bit far off. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you a further respite, maybe, I don't know. Maybe that chastisement has come to your doorsteps, I don't know. This knowledge is with Allah. إِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ الْجَهْرَ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ He, Allah, knows whatever is spoken aloud. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَكْتُمُونَ And He knows what you can see in your hearts. He knows everything. وَإِنْ أَدْرِي لَعَلَّهُ فَأَبْنَةٌ لَكُمْ And I don't know, I can't say. Maybe it is going to be another test for you. وَمَتَعُونِ الْآحِينَ Or maybe an enjoyment and respite for some time. قَالَ رَبِّحْكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ And finally the Prophet, now he is calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَبِّحْكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ Oh my Lord, now give the judgment, final judgment with truth. These words depict the psychological position of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was also now fed up. I have taken much pains. I have spent 10, 11 years in a small city. And I have been preaching here for 10, 11, 12 long years. So now, oh Lord, your judgment should come. قَالَ رَبِّحْكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ Oh my Lord, now give the final judgment with truth. رَبُّنَا الرَّحْمَانُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَى مَا تَصِفُونَ And our Lord is Rahman, the compassionate one. And only His help can be sought on those things which you are describing about Him. Now the next surah, Suratul Hajj. Actually these three surahs after, as I told you before, from Surah Yunus to this Suratul Anbiya. These are 12 surahs. And subdivided into four subgroups of three surahs. Surah Yunus, Surah Hud, Surah Yusuf. One subgroup. Surah Ra'd, Surah Ibrahim, Surah Hijr. Second subgroup. Suratul Nahl, Suratul Bani Israel, Suratul Kahf. Third group. Suratul Maryam, Suratul Taha, Suratul Anbiya. Fourth group. And now Al-Hajj and Al-Mu'minun, they are a pair. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم O mankind have fear of your Lord إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم Verily indeed the earthquake of that hour الساعة is going to be a mighty thing You know this whole solar system will be disturbed as we have in Surah Qiyamah This moon will plunge into sun. They will come together. What will happen, you know? So you can't imagine. إِنَّ زَلْدَلَةَ السَّاعَةُ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ All these mountains turned into dust, moving, just like clouds, or just like cotton, or wool. All these mountains, the Himalayas, everything. What will be happening at that time? Nobody can imagine. إِنَّ زَلْدَلَةَ السَّاعَةُ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ When that appointed hour comes, The shaking of that time would be very mighty, very great thing. يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا The day when you will see it, تَزْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ أَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ Every suckling mother would just forget the baby. Now this is the most affectionate relationship, mother and the baby. In the human beings as well as animals. But no, everybody would be caring for him and her alone. Even the suckling mothers will just forget their babies. وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلًا And all the pregnant females will lay down their pregnancy, their burden. وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى And you will see people as if they are drunk. وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى But they are not drunk. وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ But the chastisement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very severe. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُجَادِلُ فِي اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ وَيَتَّبِعُ كُلَّ شَيْطَانٍ مَرِيدٍ And there are among people who dispute concerning Allah. Although he has no knowledge, he is arguing. But he has no knowledge whatsoever. Without having any knowledge. وَيَتَّبِعُ كُلَّ شَيْطَانٍ مَرِيدٍ and he follows all the rebellious satans. Yani, as if he is a very big, you know, scholar and he is arguing against Allah, against Deen. But if you look to his character, he is a friend of Satan. He is following the ways of Satan. So these are the people, the scholars, the so-called, you know, the intelligentsia of today. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُجَادِلُ فِي اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ وَيَتَّبِعُ كُلَّ شَيْطَانٍ مَرِيدٍ كُتِبَ عَلَيْهِ. It has been prescribed on him, that is the Satan. What has been prescribed for the Satan? مَنْ تَوَلَّاهُ, whosoever will become a friend of him, فَإِنَّهُ يُضِلُّهُ, he will definitely lead him astray, وَيَهْدِيهِ إِلَىٰ عَذَابِ السَّعِيرِ, and he will guide him to the chastisement of the burning fire. Ya ayyuhan nas, O people, O mankind, in kuntum fi raybin min al-ba'ath, if you have any doubts about resurrection, how can we be resurrected? How can we be made alive again when we shall become bones and dust and nothing else? You have doubts? Now you look to your creation, your own creation. فَإِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ, you know, we created you out of clay. ثُمَّ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ, then the second stage of your creation was the sperm drop. ثُمَّ مِنْ عَلَقَةٍ, after that the third stage, a hanging piece from the wall of the womb of the mother, like a leech. ثُمَّ مِنْ مُزْغَةٍ, then a lump of flesh. مُخَلَّقَةٍ وَغَيْرَ مُخَلَّقَةٍ, formed and unformed. لِنُبَيِّنَ لَكُمْ, so that we tell you through which stages you have come here in this world. وَنُقِنُ فِي الْأَرْحَامِ مَا نَشَاءُ, and we settle in the wombs of the mothers, whatever we like, a male child or female child. إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى, we keep it there till a fixed period. ثُمَّ نُخْرِجُكُمْ تِفْلًا, then we take you out as babies. ثُمَّ لِتَبْلُغُوا أَشُدَّكُمْ, and then you reach and attain your puberty and maturity. وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُتَوَفَّى, and from amongst you are those also who die young. وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُرَدُّ إِلَىٰ أَرْضِ الْعُمَرِ, and you, some of you are returned to the most senile age. لِكَيْ لَا يَعْلَمَ مِنْ بَعْدِ عِلْمٍ شَيْئًا, so that he doesn't know anything after the knowledge he had. In the beginning he had no knowledge, but then he had all the knowledge. He attained, you know, education, and he was a PhD and this and that. But then when he is now 100 years old, now all knowledge gone. Senility has overtaken. What happened to Reagan? He couldn't, he was recognizing only his wife and none else. A person who was ruling this world at a time. But this happens. So actually, كَيْ لَا يَعْلَمَ مِنْ بَعْدِ عِلْمٍ شَيْئًا وَتَرَى الْأَرْضَ بَارِزَةً, and you see the land, you know, lying low. فَإِذَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْهَا الْمَاءَ, but when we send down water on it, rain comes. اَهْتَزَّتْ وَرَبَتْ, it stirs and swells. وَأَنْبَتَتْ فِي كُلِّ زَوْجٍ بَهِيجٍ, and then it grows every kind of lovely growth. So you have two observations. Your own creation from dust, then sperm drop, then alaqa, then muzga, all these stages. Then you come out as a baby. Then you are young, fully adult. In the same way, a land lying barren. Nothing, no life, no signs of life whatsoever. Rain comes and there is life. You see, there is vegetation. So, the God that is doing all this, can't he create you again? This is the argument which comes in Quran many times. ذَلَكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الْحَقُّ, this is so because Allah is the one who is the truth, the absolute truth. وَأَنَّهُ يُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى, and that he will revive the dead. وَأَنَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ, and that he is powerful over everything. وَأَنَّ السَّاعَةَ آتِيَةٌ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا, and that appointed hour will come. There's no doubt about it. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْعَثُ مَنْ فِي الْقُبُورِ. And Allah will definitely, surely raise them who are in the graves. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُجَادِلُ فِي اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ وَلَا هُدًى وَلَا كِتَابٍ مُنِيرٍ. Again repeating the same. But there are people who go on disputing, arguing about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can he do it? Although they have no knowledge, they have no guidance, they don't have any book with them. No divine book. ثَانِيَ عِطْفِهِ لِيُدِلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. He bends his side with arrogance so that he takes people away from the way of Allah, prevents them from the way of Allah. لَهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا خِزْيٌ. For them in this world is also humiliation. وَنُزِيقُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَذَابَ الْحَرِيقِ. And on the day of judgment, on the day of resurrection, we shall make them taste the chastisement of fire, burning fire. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.